Okay, 2x squared minus 3x equals 4. What's the first thing you should do?
Subtract 4.
Okay. Every quadratic equation has an a value, a b value, and a c value. A is?
2.
It's the coefficient of x squared. B?
-3.
Which is the coefficient of x. And C?
-4.
Okay, you with me?
Mm-hmm.
By the way, you have learned to solve quadratics by graphing. You learn to solve quadratics by square roots. You learn to solve quadratics by factoring. There's another way that you don't have to learn yet. And then this is the final way. This way always works, but it takes forever. Yeah. Now, the one on your homework tonight, when you take the square root, it's a perfect square. In other words, you could have factored it. But I want you to just practice the quadratic formula. I'm going to do a real ugly one after this ugly one. Because we changed the test to have all ugly ones. But I'm gonna also, well, I shouldn't say it on video, I'll tell you later. Okay, so x equals the opposite of b, plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. It's right here when you need it. Oh, somebody erased it. Probably me bumping into it. Okay, so let's, what's the opposite of b?
3.
Plus or minus, what's b squared?
9.
I suggest you do not put this into your calculator because you'll forget the parentheses for sure. Just do b squared. It's always going to be positive because negative times negative and positive times positive, that's always going to be positive. I'm going to play that for you when you don't do it on your test. That's always going to be positive. All right. Minus 4a, 2c, negative 4. All over 2 times 2. Now, this is where the mistake happens every single time. For people that miss a question on quadratics, they don't have plus here. If you have subtraction in the formula, and you have any negative here, just one negative, if you have two, it's a different story. If you have a negative here, it's going to be plus. So, we have 3 plus or minus 9 plus 4 times 4 times 2 is 32. All over 4. Now I'm going to erase this stuff. And work on top since I'm on film. Okay, 3 plus or minus the square root of 41 all over 4. Several ways to answer quadratic questions. You might just see it that way, which to me would be great and good enough, but apparently it's not good enough for everybody. So I'm going to show you every possible way you could see it on a multiple choice test. Actually, the best way, in my opinion, is to leave it as a radical and put 3 plus radical 41 over 4 and 3 minus radical 41 over 4. Two answers. Let's talk about how to do this on a calculator. You're going to take 3, then minus, then the second button, x squared, that's your square root, 41, and then you gotta hit equal, and then divide by 4. What do you get?
Negative
0.85. How about this one?
0.85.
No. Can't be the same. Can't be just the opposite.
2.3.
Positive 2.35? Anybody concur? Is that right? No?
I don't concur.
Well, Olivia died, so I must be right. What'd you do?
2.3.
Me? I got 2.35.
That's right there.
Yeah.
It's right there.
What do you ask me? What
did I just say?
You said you don't concur. Concur means agree.
Oh, then I concur.
You didn't know what concur.
I thought it meant.
Okay, sorry, I didn't mean to use such a big word.
I'm not.
Okay.
Advancing.
And is this one right?
Yes.
All right, another way. Now, by the way, this is radical form, and this is to the nearest hundred. Tomorrow we're going to work on giving the answer both ways so that you'll, when you see it, you'll know which, whatever one it is. They'll never have both. I'm going to change this problem to ugliness. Okay? Forget the decimal form. Let's say you worked it out and you got a 4 here. Okay? Just watch. You don't have to, I don't want the decimal answer anyway. Then you have 3 plus, that's radical 4, radical 11.
Radical 11
over 4, and 3 minus 2, radical 11 over 4. Now, you might see it as 3/4 plus radical 11 over 2. You see what I did? I divided 3 by 4, and I divided 2/4 and got 1/2. You might see that. And that would be 3/4 minus radical 11 over 2. Now, if I say simplest radical form, you get all the way to here, and then I say I want decimal form also, don't get it here. Go back to this and get your decimal form. Why go through all this? You know, 3/4 is a fraction and all that. Just go back here, get the square root of 44, add 3, equal sign, divide by 4. Why do you have to have an equal sign? How come to get this answer in decimal form, let's just talk about this for a minute so that you can understand why we're doing equal. Why do I have to hit equal before I divide by 4? Yeah?
Because like people think you're like making it like a fraction, is it? No.
Let me show you what the calculator sees if you don't hit equal. 3 plus square root of 44 divided by 4.
Doesn't divide the
3
by
4.
It doesn't divide the 3 by 4. Order of operations is what it does first, and then it adds 3. But this is really 3/4 radical 44 over 4. That's why it's just, or you can do this if you're dying to. I just think it's easier to hit equal divided by 4. Okay, because both of them are divided by 4. Just so you know. All right, I'm going to give you one. And I want you to use the quadratic formula and see what you get. Miss Rising gave me a very ugly problem. Yeah. All right. I want you to give it to me in radical form and in hundredths. And I don't expect more than 5 people to get it right. So don't worry if you don't.
I don't understand this.
What? This A equals negative 1, B equals 4, C equals 6. Use the formula. Yeah, I'll put it right here. There. And if you're at home, you should be trying it instead of watching.
Excuse me.
Who's absent?
Gabe Owen.
Mullins and Owen. Okay, while you're doing that, I'll take things. I've not worked this one out. Miss Rising did. It's hard. Period two walked out with their head spinning. No, once you divide. Whoa! You do not get negative 10. You just did what I said people were going to do wrong. This is what people will do wrong when they do it wrong. You subtracted instead of add. You should have got a 40 in that radical.
I got that.
Yeah. Whoa.
I just
what?
I got a 40.
You
got a 40? Uh-huh.
So
this is 16
plus
24.
So
yeah. Uh-huh.
That's me positive.
What
about
the negative
22
divide
in two?
What
about
dividing
in 2? Uh-uh.
Oh!
16
plus.
Negative 1.
But don't you divide?
Negative 1.1.
Yeah,
that's what I got.
I
that's one of them.
Ooh, yeah. I ended up adding because I took... Because I took the negative out at the very beginning. At the very beginning, I took the negative.
So then you made negative 4x and negative 6.
No, I made it x. Negative.
Oh!
You can't just take a negative away.
Okay. I wrote,
I forgot to add the 16.
I wrote down wrong. I wrote minus 4.
I forgot to add 16.
Here are the final answers.
No,
wait,
not yet.
X equals 4 plus 40 over negative 2.
Yeah, I got both too.
Where's it at?
Impressive. That's as hard as they get.
Really?
Well, yeah, because I was just making them up as we went along, you know. Yeah, back to the right.
Are those correct?
I'm gonna go back to the answers.
No, I'm like,
Wait,
I don't know how you guys are gonna get 21 questions done.
We got 21 questions of straight this.
Well, a lot. Well, you can do them any way you want to.
That's good.
How do you divide?
I wouldn't use the quadratic formula unless you can't factor. You can factor, factor. When would you use square roots?
When B doesn't have an X.
When there's no X. When there's nothing in front of B. When B is zero.
Okay, but how would you factor that?
You can't.
You don't.
So you have
to
There are instances where you cannot factor. And on the test, that's where I wanted to say, do it using the formula. Instead of you trying the formula every single time. But if you know how to factor, you're okay. I mean, right away, I'm looking at, well, I would have taken out the negative 1 and had x squared minus 4x minus 6. But there's no factors of 6 that are going to give you a 4. You know, 1 times 6 and 2 times 3, you can't make a 4 out of that. So you know right away you can't factor. I'm going to show you also to know how many solutions you're going to have. Let's do this one first, and then remind me to talk about the discriminant. All
right.
Discriminant is your friend. All right? Okay. The opposite of B is negative 4, plus or minus B squared, 16, minus 4, A, C. C, minus, minus. It's plus.
Whoa.
All over 2A is 1?
Negative 2.
Negative 2.